Good morning, everybody. I wish you are all fine. Let us start with a new lesson, which is vectors. Let's start by the definition of segment AB. Segment AB, it is a part of a line that joins two points A and B. So, if you are given the following line, on this line you have two points A and B, then the part of this line joining A and B is called segment AB, and you can name it as segment BA. If segment AB have sense and direction, then it is not anymore a segment, it is a vector. Then we can name it as vector AB, with A the original point and B the ending point or the terminal point. And we can denote it by the given A, the beginning point, B, the ending point, and don't forget the arrow. And this is the vector AB. We can write it in this form. Vector AB is characterized by its direction, its sense, its magnitude. Its direction is the line AB. It is a part of line AB, so it takes the direction of line AB. Its sense, from A to B, because A is the beginning point and B is the ending point. For the magnitude, it has the distance of segment AB or the length of segment AB. Vector AB is written as AB vector, A beginning point and B ending point, and don't forget to put the arrow. Vector BA is written as B the beginning point and A the ending point. Don't forget to put the arrow, and here we denoted by AB vector, and this is BA vector. We have to differentiate between a segment, between segment AB and a vector AB. What is the difference between segment AB and vector AB? Segment AB, it has only magnitude or length, but has no sense nor direction. But vector AB has sense, magnitude, and direction. We denote vector AB by the following writing: A beginning point, B ending point, and we have to put the arrow. This is A beginning point, B ending point, and this is the arrow on the vector, and this is how we denote by vector AB. Whereas segment AB, you can name it as segment BA. A and B are the points of segment AB. Note that any two points A and B in a plane can make vector AB.